to all you're fearing, believing everything went wrong. I've been hoping that you're seeing and letting go to love someone. Remember when the world was bigger, living so alive and free. Look into the magic mirror and see all you were made to be.
Wait up, you will feel it. Wake up, you will find it. It's been waiting on the other side for you there. Everybody wants a life full of love to feel alive. Everybody needs.
Holding on to all you're fearing, believing everything went wrong. I've been hoping that you're seeing and letting go to love someone. Remember when the world was bigger, living so alive and free. Look into the magic mirror and see all you were made to be.
Wait up, you will feel it. Wake up, you will find it. It's been waiting on the other side for you there. Everybody wants a life full of love to feel alive. Everybody needs.
Thank you.
holding on to all your fear and believing everything went wrong. I've been hoping that you're seeing and letting go to love someone. Remember when the world was bigger, living so alive and free. Look into the magic mirror and see all you were made to be.
Wait up, you will feel it. Wake up, you will find it. It's been waiting on the other side for you there. Everybody wants a life full of love to feel alive. Everybody needs a dream.
Holding on to all your fear and believing everything went wrong. I've been hoping that you're seeing and letting go to love someone. Remember when the world was bigger, living so alive and free. Look into the magic mirror. See all you were made to be.
Wait up, you will feel it. Wake up, you will find it. It's been waiting on the other side for you there. Everybody wants a life full of love to feel alive. Everybody needs a dream. We ain't getting younger. Everybody wants to love. To leave it.
Holding on to all you're fearing, believing everything went wrong. I've been hoping that you're seeing and letting go to love someone. Remember when the world was bigger, living so alive and free. Look into the magic mirror. See all you were made to be.
Wait up, you will feel it. Wake up, you will find it. It's been waiting on the other side for you there. Everybody wants a life full of love to feel alive. Everybody needs a dream. We ain't getting younger. Everybody wants to love.
Reach out and you will miss. Graduates, you may be seated. Welcome to the 2023 Wisconsin Connections Academy graduation ceremony. If you can't see me, I am really behind here. I feel very short behind this podium, but I am Lori Donaldson. I am the Dean of Students at WCA, and I was reminded yesterday that I should include the fact that I was the host for what I hear could possibly be the award-winning WCA Family Feud. Thank you all for coming tonight to support our graduates. We are excited to have such a great turnout for our ceremony. Also, welcome to those watching our live stream on YouTube. Thank you to 2020 WCA graduate Nicholas Langenfeld for arranging this option for our families. A special thank you to senior homeroom teachers, Mrs. Plantico, Mrs. Wershke, and Mr. Giese for working closely with our graduates to get to this point tonight. In addition, we thank Mrs. Giese for creating the senior slideshow. It is always one of the highlights of the graduation ceremony. Also, our thanks to Studio 1223 Photography, owner and photographer, as well as WCA teacher, Sarah Bauer, for taking photos tonight. Also, we would like to recognize Appleton Area School District Board Member Chris Sauter in attendance with us as well. Finally, we invite you for light refreshments immediately following the graduation ceremony. The reception will be held upstairs on the outdoor patio. The stairs, as well as the elevator, are located directly outside the auditorium. This is a big night for our graduates. It is also a special night for Wisconsin Connections Academy. We are celebrating our 21st year of educating students virtually. Some of you may not know that WCA was the first Connections Academy school in the country when we started back in 2002. Today, Connections Academy consists of 45 schools across 31 states with over 100,000 students enrolled. We did not add the high school until 2011, so our 2012 was our first graduating class. That year, we had 9 graduates with 4 attending the ceremony. This year, we have 69 graduates with 45 attending the ceremony. Over the years, traditions have formed. One of these traditions is beginning our ceremony by introducing our graduates and learning where each student is from. At this time, I would like to begin by introducing our graduates. Please hold your applause until I've introduced all of the graduates in attendance. We're going to start in the back and move to the front. So, tonight is the night for the end of the alphabet students to shine, at least for this part of the ceremony. Students, please stay standing after I call your name. Rusty Wiskowski from Baraboo. Naima Williams, Nina. Aiden Williams, Middleton. Brendan Van Engen, River Falls, who has traveled 256 miles to be here with us. Isabella Van Boxtel from Seymour. Coda Taylor Cormel from Eau Claire. Kaylin Stepig, Fredonia. Xander Smith, Green Bay. Oscar Seaholm, Madison. Basmala Salahat, Greenfield. Anna Raleigh, Medford. Preston Reese Grimm, Wautoma. Savannah Poole, Park Falls. Trinity Nicholson, Grand Marsh. Chris Newberry Lincecum, Madison. Margaret Nelson, Appleton. Maddie Motorson, Appleton. Seth Matthews, Hilbert. Anthony Martelli, Appleton. Julissa Molina Moss, Waukesha. Nolan Loomis, Blue Mounds. Ian Littlefield, Loyal. Eli Corsland, Wisconsin Rapids. Emily Kopetsky, Appleton. Kalina Koklanis, Janesville. Joseph Knox, Janesville. Charlie Kemper, River Falls. Oh, Fall River, and I did that in rehearsal and promised I wouldn't. Sorry. Sorry. Taylor Johnson, Appleton. Alden Hughesby, Twin Lakes. Evan Hunter, Appleton. Keaton Hoffman, De Pere. Morgan Garza, Green Bay. Megan Falke, Oak Creek. Genevieve Crouch, Appleton. Jillian Burkhart, Sheboygan. Taylor Bonison, Nina. Nevaeh Best, Appleton. Jacob Belts, Green Bay. Braden Beam, Waupun. Emily Barnard, Baraboo. Amelia Bartleben, Beloit. And Malik Albasama, Appleton. You may take a seat. We have a number of presenters this evening to address our graduates. Principal Michelle Miller, who has been with WCA all 21 years, will begin with the senior address.
Welcome to the 2023 Wisconsin Connections Academy graduation. Thank you, all of you, for joining us on this glorious evening to celebrate the accomplishments of these students. As a staff, we are thrilled to see our graduating class walk the stage and receive their diplomas. Congratulations, graduates. You have finished high school. Now it is time to reflect on your experience. Wisconsin Connections Academy is not a traditional school. There are no bells, no noisy hallways, no lockers or gyms. Wisconsin Connections Academy is different. It is not a building or a place, but is made up of people. It is a group of students who have made the choice to learn in a different way, to work hard using 21st century skills, to gain knowledge and understanding that will serve them in college, in work, and in life. Every year at Bay Beach, we celebrate our eighth graders moving on to high school. Last year, one of our students gave a speech, and I asked her if I could share it at graduation, as I believe it sums up many of your experiences at Wisconsin Connections Academy. Leah shared, "It is great to meet some of my fellow eighth graders in person. I was reluctant to volunteer and speak today because I do not like to publicly speak. But one thing I have learned while attending WCA and from taking other online courses is that some things always feel impossible until it is done. When I was writing this speech, it was hard to believe that we've already completed middle school. It seems like yesterday I just logged into my first lesson as a student at WCA, looking at the modules and feeling like it would take forever. I think many of you felt the same as I did, but we made it. Although we did not meet face-to-face often, I will remember the chats during live lessons, the jokes from our instructors, making connections with students from all over the state of Wisconsin, and being fortunate enough to make some friends. Attending WCA has made me more responsible. It has made me become more structured and disciplined. It has taught me how to better manage time and organize better. I have learned that I am, and we are, responsible for our educational journeys, that I am, and we are the pilots, and our instructors and parents or learning coaches are our co-pilots. I hope all will carry some of those same memories with you as we go into our next stage of not only our education, but also our lives. As we embark on this journey, I want to leave you all with the following quote by author, educator, and public speaker, Stedman Graham. "There are no limits to what you can accomplish when you know who you are and have faith in what you do." Thank you for taking your time to listen to my words. A special thank you to the WCA staffs, our family, and our friends for continuing to support us. Enjoy the rest of your day and always live your truth. All of these people are the school. Students, supporters, staff, they have worked together to make your graduation and receiving a diploma possible. In the future, when people ask about the high school you attended, let them know proudly, I went to Wisconsin Connections Academy, a great school made up of great people. There are three students, two of which are here, that I would like to recognize tonight. So I'm going to ask Jill and Rusty to stand. And Will, who's not here with us. Jill, can you stand? They don't know I'm doing this. But these three students, or the two that are here tonight, completed their entire K-12 schooling experience at WCA. So until our goodbyes become hello, go forth with my warmest wishes, and I cannot wait to see what great things you will do as you move into the new chapter of your life. Congratulations. I'm done embarrassing you, so you can sit down. To close, I have one charge for our graduates. Let this achievement motivate you, let it push you, let it guide you. And know there is no traditional path to success. Your journey is your own, and it's up to you to create it. Congratulations again. I look forward to seeing the awe-inspiring things you go out and do in the world. Set your goals high, always dream big, because you are only as big as your dreams you dare to live. Thank you.
Thank you, Mrs. Miller. You may have noticed in the program that some students are listed as National Honor Society members. In order to participate in NHS, students must have a high grade point average and commit to at least 20 hours of service per year. Our first student speaker of the evening is not only an NHS member, but she also serves as the NHS president. Trinity Nicholson has been with WCA since seventh grade. Most recently, she has been an active member and leader of the peer mentoring program. Representing the senior class, I would like to introduce Trinity Nicholson.
Hello and welcome to the Wisconsin Connections Academy 2023 graduation ceremony. It is an honor to have been given the opportunity to address you all on the behalf of my fellow graduates tonight. Firstly, I would like to congratulate my peers on stage tonight for making it here. The fact that you're sitting here today no doubt shows everyone in attendance how hard you've worked the last 12 years to make it to this moment. I would also like to extend my thanks to all of you, whether you're a fellow student, teacher, learning coach, friend, or family member of any of the people here on stage. Thank you for taking the time to make it here, even if it may have been quite a hike to be here for us today. There's a popular saying that goes, "Never forget where you came from and who helped you get there." It was this quote and a little bit of inspiration from Pinterest that inspired the design on my graduation cap. You probably didn't see it that well from your seats when I walked in, but my graduation cap has been signed by all of the people who have helped me make it through my 10-year career at WCA. This cap is a reminder to me how important it is to never forget to be thankful for all of the people who helped you along the way. So if you signed my cap, thank you for helping me make it here today. As the president of the NHS program here at WCA, I was taught to uphold the four pillars of the organization, which are service, character, scholarship, and leadership. No doubt these are all important qualities and should be applied in everyone's life, whether they're a member of NHS or not. This pillar of scholarship no doubt resonates with all of us as we move on from this chapter of our lives where scholarship was something we made use of throughout our virtual high school careers. As students in an online learning environment, we're praised for being independent and self-succeeding. While this is very true, without the persistent dedication of our learning coaches and teachers, even when we may have found it overbearing or even annoying, we would not have gained the confidence to persist through the trials that make high school what it is. My one wish for my classmates is to never forget that while we know we can succeed well enough on our own, that there's no greater feeling than knowing you have a group of people who love and support you, cheering you on as you succeed. As online learners, our high school experience was no doubt different than that of our brick and mortar peers. While our experience may not have been made by going to football games, science fairs, or school dances, we found ways to make it memorable even when our classrooms were virtual. For example, if you've been at WCA for a while, you might recall a time or two in middle school when our math teacher, Mr. McDonald, was known to throw Swiss Miss hot chocolate packets at our English teacher, Mrs. Johnston. Or you might recall getting an indescribable amount of emails from first year WCA teacher last year. No offense to Mr. Geezy. While these are only two brief experiences out of the hundreds we've gone through in our educational careers, they should go to show that even though we went to school in a different environment than most, that we were never lacking when it came to the goofy, crazy nature that high school brings. When I started writing this speech, I was reminded of a time in eighth grade when I had the opportunity to write a speech and had hoped to give it at our eighth grade commencement ceremony. Unfortunately, I ended up chickening out and I never submitted anything at all. I did this because I was scared. I was scared because the idea of high school was terrifying to me. I wanted to be prepared, but I had no idea what I was preparing for, and this foreign feeling was no doubt not a very fun time for me. What I mean by telling you this is that it feels as though yesterday I was this eighth grade student, absolutely terrified at the looming threat that was high school. Today, I'm here, still absolutely petrified, no doubt, but luckily not because I'm preparing to go through all of this again. Some of us may be feeling scared and overwhelmed at the idea of adulthood, a concept we're quite foreign to, and others may be ready and waiting in their seats to grab their diplomas and run out the front door. Regardless of how we're feeling right now, something I want my fellow graduates to know is that even though adulthood may seem daunting, I know we're all going to succeed just as much in life as we did in the classroom. Finally, I want to thank some of the people who have made my high school experience well worth it. My parents for being my built-in learning coaches, to all my friends that made going to live lessons each week worth it, and to all the teachers that I've had the honor of being taught by. Teachers like Mr. McDonald, Mrs. Johnston, Mrs. Lytle, Mrs. Wershke, Mr. Geezy, Mrs. Noto and her awesome corny jokes, Mrs. Peachy, Mr. Vanderlaat, Mr. Lemahue, and so many others. If I mentioned every teacher who had an impact on me as a student, this speech would go on forever, even if it feels as though this speech has gone on forever already. I know I speak on behalf of all my fellow graduates tonight. We would not be where we are today without the help of all of you. I want to leave my graduates with one final quote that one of my favorite teachers, Mr. Vanderlaat, always includes at the end of his emails. There is no end to education. It is not that you read a book, pass an examination, and finish with education. The whole of life, from the moment you're born to the moment you die, is a process of learning. Fellow graduates, I wish the best for all of you in the years to come. I know we're all going to do remarkable things in this world. It is truly an honor and a privilege to say that I was part of the class of 2023 with some amazing people like you. Thank you.
Thank you, Trinity. Every year, Mrs. Wershke sends an email asking if any of the graduates are interested in singing at the ceremony. This year, however, Mrs. Wershke had no need to do so. Megan Falke, a current senior and one of tonight's graduates, volunteered already last year to perform at tonight's ceremony. Tonight, she is singing Almost There from Princess and the Frog. I present you, Megan Falke.
That's just gonna have to wait a while. Ain't got time for messing around, and it's not my style. This whole town can slow you down, people taking the easy way. But I know exactly where I'm going, getting closer and closer every day. And I'm almost there, I'm almost there. Oh, people around here think I'm crazy, but I don't care. Trials and tribulations, I've had my share. Oh, there ain't nothing gonna stop me now, and I'm almost there. I remember Daddy told me, oh, very fairy tales can come true. You gotta make them happen, it all depends on you. So I work real hard each and every day. Now things for sure I go my way. Just doing what I do. Oh, look at the world I'm coming through, and I'm almost there. I'm almost there. Oh, people gonna come in from everywhere, and I'm almost there. My share, but I climbed a mountain and I crossed a river. I'm almost there. I'm almost there. I'm almost there. Do 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 do. I'm almost there.
Thank you, Megan. As promised, I was your backup dancer backstage, so did a nice job. For our distinguished speaker this year, we invited Nanette Bunno, Appleton Area School District Assistant Superintendent of Schools, to speak to our graduates. Nan has worked in different capacities over the 23 years she's been employed by the Appleton Area School District. Nan began her career in the district as a principal at Edison Elementary School, and then served another 4 years as principal at Franklin Elementary School. She left Franklin to serve as the Director of Humanities in the Assessment, Curriculum, and Instruction Department. Nan worked in this capacity for 8 years prior to becoming the Assistant Superintendent of School Services. She has been in this role for 7 years and currently oversees WCA. I present Appleton Area School District Assistant Superintendent of Schools. That is a big title, Nan. Just gonna say. So, without further ado, and no more titles, Nan Bunno.
Wisconsin Connections Academy graduating seniors, family members, guests, and staff, it's both a privilege and an honor for me as Assistant Superintendent in the Appleton Area School District to have the opportunity to speak at tonight's ceremony celebrating this wonderful graduating class of 2023, recognizing all of your accomplishments and all of the possibilities that await you. A lot of things had to happen to get you here today, but you're right where you need to be. I'm so thankful for the unique learning opportunities that Wisconsin Connections Academy provides for you and for the flexibility and support it offers you and your families. The Appleton Area School District has long embraced the reality of one size doesn't fit all. In doing that over the years, we have developed many innovative educational opportunities for our students and families, providing multiple choices and options. With 13 charter schools, 22 neighborhood schools, one magnet school, and multiple other unique programs, we're able to offer a wide variety of teaching and learning experiences to benefit all of our students to ensure success for every student every day. To the parents and family members of WCA graduates, I would like to extend our appreciation to you for allowing us to play a role in the educational growth of your children. As educators, it's our greatest joy to see students mature into successful young adults. Partnerships with our families and students are crucial to student success. It's very heartening to see families like you that are so involved and supportive in your students' education. Today is a celebration not only for our graduates, but for your work and support for them as well. To our graduating seniors, your parents, families, and teachers have watched over you and have done their best to provide you with rigorous curriculum along with support needed to prepare you for the next step in your journey. Always remember with gratitude the great things they did for you to help get you to this day. Consider finding a moment to thank them tonight. Students, although we don't know each other personally, I would venture to say that you are individuals who are innovative and like to explore new things. You are a talented and special group of students that in many cases have taken the road less traveled to achieve your goals. These are traits that likely led you down a path to a virtual charter school and are wonderful qualities to be able to compete in our ever-changing society. As students in an innovative learning environment like WCA, you have already been pioneers in the field of learning. You have gone beyond the traditional approach to education by exploring your own path to learning with your learning coaches and teachers as your guide. You've learned through virtual classrooms, online research, phone conferences, and much more. While the academic knowledge and expertise you have gained to this point is only the beginning, you have gained the skills to be successful no matter what the circumstances. As seniors who survived and navigated education through a global pandemic, we are proud of you and confident in your ability to meet the challenges ahead of you. We encourage you to use your abilities in this area to assist others who may not be as comfortable with challenges or change or innovation. Please remember to pay it forward by reaching out to support others along the way as you continue your journey beyond high school. Getting to this stage tonight has required a great deal of persistence. Persistence in completing assignments, passing tests, persistence in being present in the virtual classroom on a consistent basis, and persistence in producing work that met the high standards of the WCA curriculum and your graduation requirements. I also know that many of you have had to persist in traveling long distances to complete assessments, complete state tests, attend graduation ceremonies over the years. All of these examples solidify that you demonstrate your determination and tenacity. Persistence is an essential quality for all of us, as students, as teachers, as family members, as employers, and as employees in every walk of life. After graduation, there will be many new opportunities for you to find your unique calling in this world. With every pathway to success, there will be another set of challenges, another set of opportunities, and another set of circumstances that may lead you to change how you approach your goals and your responsibilities. You have proven to everyone gathered here tonight that you have the ability to complete a journey with persistence and with innovation, despite the many changes and challenges that you've experienced over your 13 years in education. Upon graduation, no matter how you arrived at this point, you are a success. In conclusion, on behalf of the Appleton Area School District Board of Education and the Appleton Area School District leadership team, congratulations to all of you on your graduation. Although your time as a student at WCA and in the Appleton Area School District is coming to an end, know that we will always be here to support you. We look forward to hearing about your accomplishments and successes in the future and wish you only the best on your journey. Congratulations.
Thank you, Nan, whose title I practiced in backstage while she was speaking. It's really, hopefully I do it without stumbling, the Appleton Area School District Assistant Superintendent of Schools. Got through it. Our first speaker, Trinity, served as National Honor Society President. Our next speaker, Jacob Belts, is also a member of the National Honor Society. In addition, I'm pleased to announce that Jacob is WCA's recipient of the Technical Excellence Scholarship. The Technical Excellence Scholarships are awarded by the state of Wisconsin to Wisconsin high school seniors who have demonstrated the highest level of proficiency in technical education subjects. The scholarships are only for use at a school within the Wisconsin Technical College system located within the state. Jacob has been accepted and plans to attend Northeast Wisconsin Technical College. Please join me in congratulating Jacob and also welcoming him as our next speaker.
Good evening, everyone. I'm very honored to be speaking on this momentous occasion. As said by Mrs. Donaldson, my name is Jacob Belts, and I have been a student at Wisconsin Connections Academy for 9 years. I would like to begin with a little bit about myself and how I came to this school, an origin story of sorts. I attended a brick and mortar school from kindergarten through third grade. In my third grade year, I had 3 different teachers. The first one got fired after 2 months, the second one was a substitute for 2 months, and the third one was brand new to teaching for the rest of the year. Because 3 different teachers were assigned to our class, there was a lack of consistency in teaching style and discipline. As a result, some of my foundational skills suffered, like reading comprehension. This put me at a disadvantage academically and led my parents on the path of changing schools. My parents looked at neighboring school districts, homeschooling, and then happened upon virtual schooling. Wisconsin Connections Academy was one of the first virtual schools that appeared in the search. We initially liked WCA because of the physical proximity to our home and the flexibility it offered compared to other schooling programs. I don't think it hit me until the first day at the Welcome Back event that things were going to be different. The excitement of the event and the people welcoming me started to allow me to be comfortable with my circumstances. I will be honest, I was reluctant to move schools. I remember feeling nervous and excited as I started this new chapter of my life. I honestly did not know what was to come in the next year, 5 years, or even 10 years. At the time, I did not realize it, but this experience was going to change the trajectory of my life. I was very quick to judge this school, and as a result, I had pretty low expectations. Learning from home did not sound appealing in the slightest. Being at home all day was an appalling concept to me. However, I quickly retracted these assumptions after experiencing the atmosphere of the school. The family-like atmosphere of the staff was incredibly welcoming. Connexus, now known as Pearson Online Classroom, was mind-blowing to me at the time. I had access to every lesson planned for me in the school year, an emailing system for within the school, and an online classroom to interact with teachers and students. All of these concepts were completely new to me, but I got used to them, regardless of their evolution throughout my 9 years at the school. In spite of this, there was one thing that I never got used to being at this school, and that was its perception. When I talked to almost anyone about when I go to school, whether a hairdresser, store clerk, or some family and friends, I proudly say I attend Wisconsin Connections Academy. Then there's some sort of facial expression indicating they don't know what it is, and then they ask, "So you are homeschooled?" For some reason, this rubbed me the wrong way. It almost seemed like a demeaning comment, like being homeschooled would be bad. I think that I just wish more people knew about virtual schooling and the opportunities it gives kids to be successful like me and my fellow peers who are on this stage tonight. The caps and gowns that we are wearing tonight represent our academic success and what is to come in our futures. It is without a doubt we could not have made it this far without our teachers. Without this fantastic group of teachers, I do not think my experience and many of my peers' experiences at this school would be as enjoyable. The teachers provide a sense of belonging that creates a family of sorts. They truly care about our success. I've never met a teacher or staff member at Wisconsin Connections Academy that has not put a great deal of effort into making it possible for every student to succeed. They offer so many resources like study guides, well-planned live lessons, and announcement pages to keep their students well-informed. There are too many memories of funny student and teacher interactions to count. I've had a chance to interact with most teachers and staff throughout my time here, and they are truly phenomenal people. For their dedication to all the students and families at WCA, let's give them a round of applause. Now, I know how nerve-wracking it is to be finished with high school. Your future is now at your feet. Gone are the days of daydreaming about what you will do as an adult after high school, because they are here. It is stressful trying to picture and form a plan in such a short span of time. The good news is that you do not have to have a full blueprint for your life. Whatever you choose to do, though, I encourage everyone to continue their education. Maybe you choose not to go to college, but keep learning new things, because an investment in knowledge always pays the best interest. Learn to play a new instrument. Learn how to code. Learn how to grow your own food. Learn how to change a car part. Learn how to invest your money wisely. Or even learn how to build a house. It really doesn't matter what the things are. Just keep your brain active. Keep your body active. And get some sunshine. This will help you hold a positive outlook on life. Benjamin Franklin once said, "Life is 10% what happens to you and 90% how you respond to it." We lived through the COVID-19 pandemic and the challenges it brought. Staying at home and not having face-to-face contact with anyone was quite difficult. I believe that we responded incredibly well as a school because we have always been online. Our education did not suffer. Never have I ever related to Benjamin Franklin's words more than through my high school years. Learning to be more patient in my reactions to the events around me has been difficult. That portfolio is due today, having a disagreement with siblings, the final exam week is coming up, having not done chores for the week are all things that have tested my patience. Take it one step at a time. That is how I view life. Take it one step at a time. It does not matter how many steps you take. You need to enjoy the journey. Look forward to the destination, but enjoy the road there. The little moments in life count. The laughs, the tears, the smiles, and the sadness. As Dr. Seuss once said, sometimes you will never know the value of a moment until it becomes a memory. I encourage every graduate to continue to be themselves, try new things, and enjoy their journey towards whatever destination they set. Thank you to those in the audience that have come to celebrate this huge milestone of achievement with me and my classmates. Congrats to the class of 2023.
Thank you, Jacob. I've met your siblings, so I don't know how they could be a challenge. They always seem so sweet. Thank you to all of the presenters this evening. And now let's get to the moment you've all been waiting for. At this time, we would like to present the graduates with their diplomas. Graduates in the first row, please rise. When I call your name, you'll please cross the stage to receive your diploma. Malik Abusama. Amelia Bartalaban. Emily Barnard. Braden Beam. Jacob Belts. Nevaeh Best. Taylor Bonison. Jillian Burkhart. Genevieve Crouch. Megan Falke. Morgan Garza. Keaton Hoffman. Evan Hunter. Second row, please rise. Alden Huseby. Taylor Johnson. Charlie Kemper. J. Joseph Knox. Kaylina Kolkanis. Come on. Emily Kopetsky. Eli Corslin. Ian Littlefield. Nolan Loomis. Jaleesa Molina Moss. Anthony Martelli. Seth Matthews. Maddie Motorson. Margaret Nelson. Chris Newberry Linsicum. The last row, please rise. Trinity Nicholson. Leah Patterson. Savannah Poole. Preston Reese Grimm. Anna Raleigh. Yay, Anna! Basmala Salahat. Oscar Seaholm. Xander Smith. Kaylin Stepping. Coda Taylor Cormel. Isabella Van Boxtel. Brendan Van Engen. Aiden Williams. Naima Williams. Rusty Wiskowski. I hereby certify that these students have met the high school graduation requirements required by the state of Wisconsin. Students, you may turn your tassel from the right to the left. Ladies and gentlemen, the class of 2023. Before our graduates are dismissed, I'd like to remind you that you can join us for refreshments upstairs on the outdoor patio.